Hello and welcome to the session on the course Discrete Mathematical Structures. The topic Semigroups and Monoids under second year of Information Technology Engineering semester 1. At the end of this session, students will be able to demonstrate semigroups and monoids and its properties. These are the contents: semigroups and monoids, definitions and examples, homomorphism of semigroups and monoids. In the last video, we have learnt about algebraic structures, that is algebraic systems, and its various properties. This is an extension of algebraic system where we learn semigroups and monoids. So let's understand what is a semigroup. Here is the definition. Let S be a non-empty set and dot be a binary operation on S. The algebraic system S, dot is called a semigroup if the operation dot is associative. In other words, S, dot is a semigroup if for any x, y, z which belongs to S, x dot y dot z is equal to x dot y dot z, which is nothing but the property of associativity, which we have also seen when we learnt about algebraic systems. So now, here we can differentiate between an algebraic system being a semigroup. It is an algebraic system which possesses the property of associativity. A semigroup may or may not have an identity element with respect to the operation dot. We have seen examples of algebraic systems which also have an identity element. For example, the set of integers, set of natural numbers, and so on. Next, monoid. Here is the definition. A semigroup M, dot with an identity element with respect to the operation dot is called a monoid. Now, what is a monoid? It is simply an extension of a semigroup and which holds the property of having an identity element with the respect to the operation dot. So we can say every monoid is a semigroup which has an identity element. In other words, an algebraic system M, dot is called a monoid if for any x, y, z which belongs to M, x dot y dot z is equal to x dot y dot z, which is again the property of associativity, which we have seen earlier in the semigroup definition. And there exists an element E belongs to M such that for any X belongs to M, we have E dot X, which is same as X dot E, and which is nothing but equal to X. So X is any element and E is an identity element for the monoid. A monoid has a unique or a distinguished element called the identity of the monoid. So, let's proceed with examples now. Here are some of the examples which will make you understand what is a semigroup and a monoid in a better way. So, starting with the first example, let X be a non-empty set and X raised to X, which we also called as X to the power of X, be the set of all mappings from X to X. Let dot denote the operation of composition of these mappings. That is, for f, g belongs to x raised to x, f dot g given by f dot g of x is equal to f of g of x. Note the symbols that we have used. For all x belongs to x in x raised to x. The algebra X raised to X, dot is a monoid because the operation of composition is associative and the identity mapping f of x equal to x for all x belongs to x is the identity of the operation. And just now we have seen the definition for a monoid. A monoid is a semigroup which has an identity element. And also, a semigroup is an algebraic system where the operation with respect to the semigroup is associative in nature. So, continuing with this manner, this example explains you What is a semigroup and what is a monoid? Let's see another example now. Example 2. Let B of X denote the set of all relations from X to X and dot mean the composition of relations on B of X. Now, the algebraic system B of X, dot is a monoid in which the identity relation is the identity of the monoid. And we all know what is an identity relation. So in this example, what is an identity for this particular monoid? Here, it is the identity relation itself which acts as an identity for the monoid B of X, dot. And also, continuing with the semigroup definition, B of X, dot is also a semigroup where the dot operation is associated. Now, an assignment where you will try to find out this question. Let N be the set of natural numbers. Then, define algebraic systems N, plus and N, into, where plus is the operation of addition and into is the operation of multiplication. What are these? Semigroups or monoids? Here is the answer. Both the systems N, plus and N, into are monoids with the identities 0 and 1 respectively. I hope you can understand the identities being 0 for addition and 1 for multiplication. As any element from set of natural numbers, if you perform addition with 0, it gives you the same number itself. Similarly, if you perform multiplication of any element of set of natural numbers with 1, it gives you the same number itself. So, it is clear that for addition, the identity element is 0, which also belongs to the set of natural numbers. And for the operation of multiplication, the identity element is 1, which also belongs to the set of natural numbers. And obviously, these are also semigroups, as both the operation of addition as well as the operation of multiplication are both associative in nature. Lastly, consider this example. If capital E denotes the set of positive even numbers, then what can be said about these algebraic systems? E, plus and E, into. Algebraic systems, namely E, plus and E, into, are only semigroups because they only satisfy the property of associativity. Since it contains only the positive even integers or positive even numbers, while finding an identity for addition, it is difficult to find in such. Similarly, finding an identity for multiplication from set of positive even numbers, it is not possible. Now, as we have learned various properties of an algebraic system, same we are going to learn in terms of semigroups as well as monoids. Starting with the first property being that of homomorphism. Definition: let S, star and T, delta be any two semigroups. A mapping G from S to T such that for any two elements, A, B belongs to S. G of A star B is equal to G of A delta G of B is called a semigroup homomorphism. Just like algebraic systems, a semigroup homomorphism is called a semigroup monomorphism if it is the mapping is 1-to-1. It is called as a semigroup epimorphism if the mapping G is an onto, and it is called as a semigroup isomorphism if the mapping G is 1-to-1 onto. So, similar to the algebraic system, the same applicable to semigroups. Now, two semigroups S, star and T, delta are said to be isomorphic if there exists a semigroup isomorphic mapping from S to T. This is also similar to the algebraic system definition that we have learnt, isomorphic images of each other. So same, S, star and T, delta are isomorphic mappings from S to T, but in case of a semigroup. Next comes a definition for homomorphism of monoids. Let M comma star comma E of M and T comma delta comma E of T be any two monoids, where E of M denotes the identity for first algebraic system and E of T denotes the identity for the second. A mapping G from M to T such that for any two elements A comma B belongs to M, G of A star B is equal to G of A delta G of B, and G of E of M is same as E of T. What does that mean? When you apply the definition of identity element, we find that the mapping G of applied on the identity element of the first set M gives you the identity element for the second. Now this is called a monoid homomorphism. So similar to the semigroup homomorphism, we have a similar condition given by G of A star B equal to G of A delta G of B, and we have an additional condition where it relates to the identity elements of the two sets. G of EM must be same as E of T. A homomorphism of a semigroup into itself is called a semigroup endomorphism, while an isomorphism onto itself is called a semigroup automorphism. These are also in line with the definitions of same in case of algebraic system. These are the references. In the next video, we are going to learn more about semigroups and monoids with respect to sub-semigroups and sub-monoids. Thank you.